In this video, we're going to talk about what happens when you make an edit to a corridor, specifically what you need to do to make your corridor display properly after you've made that edit. Inside of Civil 3D, oftentimes when you make a modification to something inside of a drawing, you have to rebuild that object. And corridors are no different. If I go into my corridor and I right click and I go to my corridor properties and I go to some information on my region, for the first section of my region, and I change the frequency of my placement of my assemblies, then what I'm gonna go ahead and do is I'm gonna modify along tangents, curve increments, along spirals, along vertical curves, all to 10 feet. And I'm gonna go ahead and hit okay. And what Civil 3D is gonna do is it's gonna give me a warning sign that says that something is out of date. And if I hit okay, what Civil 3D is going to ask me to do is rebuild the corridor. If for some reason Civil 3D didn't give me that warning and didn't ask me to rebuild it, what I could do is I could go over to the dev core, right click and choose rebuild. And what would end up happening is then my corridor would rebuild and it would be displayed properly. And you can see that now I have my assemblies placed at a more frequent interval along the first portion of my alignment in this region here, and then as I move into the next region, the original frequency takes over. Before we move into the next video though, I'm going to go ahead and select this corridor and I'm going to delete it.